did not know anything about visual arts, because in my family the focus was on literature and performing arts. Mm-hmm. But when I went to America, I started going to museums and seeing painting, especially the Art Institute of Chicago, which is one of my favorite, still one of my favorite museums in the world. Mm-hmm. And then I got exposed to painting. And then when I went to Europe, more and more I got to see the museums over there. And out of that, I learned a little bit about Indian art and I started collecting paintings, And then when I started collecting paintings, I didn't really know anything about Indian artists. So I was learning as I went along. And then one day I saw a Jamini Roy painting for the first time in my life. And once I saw that, I fell in love. And after that, every time I went to buy a painting, a Jamini Roy versus something else, I always ended up buying the Jamini Roy. And then I did that for about 20 years. And then it turned out that, the collection was rather large, and I had two curators who were helping me manage the collection. And then I realized I can't buy any more Jamini Roys, because basically every time I proposed to the curators that I want to buy a new one, they looked at it and they said, no, it's just going to be a duplicate of what you have, or a variation of what you have, and it's not going to add to the collection. So then I started collecting other artists about 10, 15 years ago. Okay. And so then I collected new Bengal school artists. I had collected some other early Bengal oils and Kalighats and all before that, but 60% of my acquisitions were Jamini Roy in a 20-year period. And then after that, only 40% were other artists. But then after that, in the last 10, 15 years, I also added some other artists. So now I've, ended up with, by default, one of the largest collection of Bengal school art between 1870 and 1950. That's my focus. Mm-hmm. It's about the emergence of modern Indian art. And the emergence of modern Indian art took place in a focused way at the Government College of Art in Calcutta around 1910. That is when Indian artists started asking the question, having been trained by the British art schools into Western academic art, they started asking the question, what is modern Indian art? And how is it different from Western academic art? And so there were various answers given at that time, of which four were the most prominent. One was the Bengal school led by Abhindranath Tagore, who basically rejected the Western academic art and took Mughal and Rajput inspiration, married it with Japanese wash techniques to make a pan-Asian movement. And that was the original Bengal nationalist school, the first nationalist school of art in modern Indian art history. Mm-hmm. But then there were three other artists who rebelled against that nationalist school, Bengal school. One was Hemant Mazumdar, who said, I love Western academic art, but I'm going to paint Indian femininity using Western academic art techniques, and that had never been done before. And he captured Indian femininity in a way which nobody else before or after has ever done. And basically, he's most famous for his wet sari paintings, which was the wet sari paintings from where Bollywood got its inspiration.
Okay.
The second artist was Jamini Roy, who said, I don't want to paint in the Western style. I want to paint in the Indian style, but I don't want to paint I want to be a modern artist, not like a traditional artist, the way Abhindranath Tagore and the nationalist movement is. So he dipped into the well of imagination of the Kalighat and the Patwa, Bengali Patwas, who did one unbroken line and then filled the plane with color. It was a very flat technique, which was the opposite of Western art, which was very much about perspective and light and about oil on canvas. And he stayed true to the Indian watercolor on paper and had a flat perspective. And so he's in some sense the father of Indian modern art in terms of painting. And then the third artist was Rabindranath Tagore, who said, I'm Indian, I'm modern. Whatever I paint is Indian modern art. And I don't want to be like a branded cattle that I have to produce something that is called Indian art. I produce whatever. And he was inspired by the German expressionists mostly. And his paintings as an untrained artist reflect his luxuriant imagination on paper. And he started painting at the age of 60, saying there are some things, even after winning the Nobel Prize in Literature, that I cannot express in words. And so he started painting. And so those are the three or four major artists that I collect.